easier to calculate manually. Okay, so then with this, we can put our formula a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. Okay, then after that, solve it as d. 9 times 9 is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, because of the square. Then 2 times 8 is 16, 16 times 9. Sorry, I need to do this, 54. 9 and 5, 1, 4, 4, 0, 0. Plus 64. Okay, then I believe the last step you can do yourself. Right? Okay, then after that question 7a. 7a, the problem is slightly because of the fraction. Okay. So 1/5a plus 3b bracket square. We apply our formula of a plus b bracket square. Okay, so this was when we apply a minus b bracket square. Okay, so over here we will then be getting a square plus 2ab plus b square. So upon expansion, okay, your a will be 1/5a. So make sure there are brackets around it. Plus 2ab. Okay. Then after that, plus b square. B is your 3b. Make sure there are brackets around the 3b as well. Okay. Then after that, simplify it. You will get 1/5 bracket square. Press into your calculator. You will get 1/25a square. 2 times 1/5 times 3, that will give us 6/5ab. I hope nobody is writing this as a mixed number. Okay, it should be an improper fraction, 6/5. Then 3 squared is 9. So we get 9b squared. So that will be the answer. Okay. So for question 8a, you will then be applying this formula. Right, then next we look at question 9a. Question 9a, I will suspect that
x plus 3.
You cannot bring it in and then your 4 ends up getting squared. your 4 itself does not have a square. Okay? So, we only look at, in fact, since you're leaving the 4 behind, we will then only focus on this expansion first. And that will give us a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. Okay, this is the expansion that we get. Right? So you must leave the 4 behind. In the second part, then we have negative 3 times x plus 4 times x minus 4. Likewise, we leave the negative 3 behind. We only focus on this x plus 4 times x minus 4, for which we know that it is going to give us a squared minus b squared, so x squared minus 4 squared. Okay? So again, we leave the negative 3 behind. Right? And then we simplify first before we continue. So this will give us x squared plus 6x plus 9, negative 3, x squared minus 16. Okay. Then from here, now that we have tackled the main part, we have it this way, then we can now bring in the 4 into the question, and then the negative 3 into the question as well. So we get 4x squared plus 24x plus 26 minus 3x squared plus 3 times 16 is what? Huh? Okay, thank you. Okay, and then I believe the last step should be able to fill. Okay, simplify also. Right? Questions? Okay, I want to explain. Okay, why is it that 4 times x plus 3 squared is not the same as 4x plus 12 squared? Okay, so as I briefly mentioned earlier on, because 4 is not being squared, but even if you tackle the expansion, for this one we have already seen it over here. Okay. We saw the answer here already, which is 4 times x squared plus 6x plus 9. Right? But then for this 4x plus 12 bracket squared, what happens when we were to expand it? If I were to apply my formula, I will get a squared, which is my 4x squared, plus 2ab, followed by plus b squared. And now my 4 undergoes a square, so I'll get 16x squared plus 96x plus 144. Okay, and this will be the result. But what we saw over here was that this actually gives us 4x squared plus 24x plus 6. Okay? So we cannot anyhow have this C bracket, see a number outside, then bring everything inside. Bingo. Right? It doesn't work. Okay? The main reason is because the square only belongs to these things inside the brackets. It does not belong to the four. Okay? So I want us to be careful about that. Right? Last one. Question 11. Is it? Okay. How many of you? something that we can do, because there's nothing else that we can do over here. X squared plus y squared, there's no formula for that. Our formula is x squared minus y squared. Okay, so the only natural thing for us to do is to expand the thing that we want to find first. Okay, and that will mean that we apply our formula. Okay, a squared plus 2ab plus b squared. Okay. For which we need to simplify, half squared is giving us 1/4. Then after that, we are left with half xy here, followed by 1/4 y squared. Okay. So you need to be able to identify what is the problem that you're facing in this question. Is it a matter of expansion or is it a matter of simplifying? Okay. Expansion is where we apply the formula. Okay. Simplifying is where maybe you don't know that half square will give us 1/4. Or maybe you forgot about the brackets. Okay. Then from here, we apply what we already know from here. Okay. So we intentionally put the 1/4 x squared plus 1/4 y squared together. I'll explain to you in a moment why I did this. Okay, I rearrange the terms, I get this. Right? I erase this question pen here. Yeah? In this pair, what is a common factor? 1/4, right? Okay, if I were to take out 1/4, what would I be left with? X squared plus y squared, isn't it? Okay, and then after that, I have half xy, which is half times xy. Okay, so I intentionally put the brackets over there so that you can see what I'm going to do next. I'm going to take the values that I know and replace what's inside the brackets. X squared plus y squared is 14. Okay, here. So 1/4 times 14 plus half, and xy was given to us as 5. Okay, so with 1/4 times 14 plus half times 5, okay, I think you can just take the calculator and get the answer. Just one step. Okay. Right? Okay, any questions? Right? If you are good with our corrections ready, could you please submit your homework to the front?
Okay,
so about 78% of you okay, then about 20% of you are not that confident. Okay, so hopefully after today's lesson, you work out in being able to know how to factorize using the cross method. Right? Now, I want to revisit this slide. I believe this slide should be familiar to you if you have watched the video. Okay? So, our cross method itself, okay, stop trying to react, okay, the focus should be here. Alright, the cross method itself requires us to have our frame being drawn. Okay, the frame needs to look something like that. Alright? So when we have our 3x squared plus 10x minus 8, we learn that our 3x squared must be here, negative 8 must be here, and plus 10x must be here. Okay, so we need to arrange the terms, and there's a fixed method of arranging the terms. It must be the term with a power of 2 here, constant term followed by the term with a power of 1. Okay, this one has power of 2, this one has power of 1. Okay, this area over here is where we do our multiplication, and the one on the right, okay, this column here is where we do addition. Okay, so we need to consider what is it that will multiply with each other to give us 3x squared. So we have our 3x times our x. Okay, to give us 3x squared, that is a very natural consideration for us. For negative 8, okay, we usually, or what I recommended in the video, was to ignore the minus sign and just consider the 8 to be 4 and 2. Okay, perhaps we do that first. Alright, but if we were to do this and I cross multiply, okay, I'm going to get x times 4, following the line, I'll get 4x. And then 3x times 2, I will get 6x. Okay? While we see that plus 4x and plus 6x upon addition, it does give us plus 10x. But if I bring the sign over here, plus, and now this plus, I notice that positive 4 times positive 2 does not give us negative 8. So this consideration over here is not correct. So I cannot conclude that 3x plus 4 and x plus 2 is the answer. Okay? So then I will need to go about doing a switch. So instead of 4 and 2, maybe we can go 2 and 4. Okay? I did not change the factors at all, I just changed the arrangement. Why does it matter? It is because just by changing the arrangement, I'm multiplying a different thing. Down here, this 4 will multiply with the 3x. Okay, Lucas, I don't know what are you doing. Alright, 4 times 3, I'm going to get 12x. And x times 2, I'm going to get 2x here. So it affects what I'm going to be getting here. And I know that, okay, if I remove all the signs first, for 2x and 12x to, in the end, add up to give us 10x, I can consider a positive 12x and a minus 2x. Okay? Whereby this sum can give us a positive 10x. So this column here is satisfied. Then I bring the sign here and the sign here, and I find that negative and plus, okay, it won't give me negative 8. Sorry, I don't know why I erased that just now. Okay, so negative multiplied with a plus will give us a negative 8. And this is also correct. So therefore, I can then conclude by reading horizontally that 3x minus 2 times x plus 4 is giving us the answer. Okay? So that will be how we do the cross method. I know that for some of us, okay, we maybe follow the method in the textbook. You can do that. Okay, I'm not stopping you from doing it. But I'm going to only teach one method, and that is the cross method. So that it's easier for all of us. Okay, and consistent as well. Right? So that is the summary of the cross method. Okay? My next question is, I know how to check my answer after factorizing a quadratic expression. Is it true or false? Okay, how do we check our answer? Okay, this one also no points. Because it's just four. Person have an answer. Huh? Yeah, but there's 33 students in the class. without any spacing. We want to practice typing. So x plus 3 times 2x minus 5.
Thank you.
6 times x plus 2. Okay? I noticed that there are a few of you who still don't know how to factorize. Okay? So to give everyone a chance to answer rather than not be able to successfully answer anything in this quiz, alright, I want us to pause what we're doing, okay, and have our attention on the whiteboard. Okay? How do we factorize x squared plus 8x plus 12? Okay? We need to have our x squared from here, plus 12 here, and plus 8x. Okay, that's how we need to arrange our terms first. Then we're focusing on multiplying. So x times x will give us x squared. Okay? Now, what times what will give us 12? What is the natural choice for you? 2x6, okay? But I think even for myself, my natural inclination is 4x3. Okay, but it really depends on yourself. Okay? You can consider 4x3, but we know the answer already. Okay, we consider 2x6. Okay? Then we do our cross multiplication. We will have x times 2 over here, 2x. Following the line, x times 6, we get 6x. Okay? Then after that, we check the signs. We know that 2x plus 6x, when they are both positive, it will give me a positive 8x. So we are adding over here. Okay, looking at the sum. Over here, we're looking at multiplication. So I bring the positive sign here and the positive sign here. And I check that the multiplication, okay, is going to give us positive 12. So positive 2 times positive 6 will give us positive 12. Okay, and therefore I conclude that I have x plus 2 times x plus 6 as the answer. I noticed that in the presentation, some of you, okay, only write this part. You did not write down what is the eventual answer. So please keep in mind to write down the eventual answer. Okay, you know about this already. Now let's move on to the next question. Okay, so far, top 2 and highest. Okay, that's your question 2 already. Thank you. 7. Okay, so I shall not go through this since everyone's getting this correct. Okay, we next move on to the third one. Scoreboard now. Group 1 at the highest. Okay, we will close number of points to 23 as well. Okay, so that's your chance. Third question, 3x squared plus 10x minus 8. Multiply to give us negative 8. Okay, so this should be the answer. I want us to remember that you cannot just give this as answer. You do not get marks in the exam by presenting your answer this way only. You only get a mark when you are able to successfully write for me that 3x minus 2 times x plus 4 is the answer. Okay? So I want us to make sure that our presentation is right. In fact, if you are able to become so skillful in doing factorization, you may reach a stage where you don't even need this anymore. Okay, and that is what I'm also trying to push my centuries, okay, to do. Okay, to stop relying on this to be able to instantly do your factorization. Okay, but of course you're only starting out, please do this, okay? But make sure you write down your answer this way. Okay, because this is factorization. This is just a process, okay, just a working. Alright? Last question. Okay, so group 3 managed to write up.
No.
Last question. 8x squared plus 2x minus 15. You should know by now that the faster you key in your answer, the more points you get. Okay, using the cross method.